Serie A matches of the week. We have a lot of very interesting action, beginning with Inter and Udinese. Inter will be 5-2 for the season. It is Inter Milan that has to march to 52. Inter go on top of the table with the win over Udinese, which has a very strong start to the season. Inter are on top of the table. And then we move to Monza and Juventus. Juventus unbeaten, 2 wins, 4 draws. It is Monza that has to march to 24. It is also Juventus that has to march of 24, so making sense of the 2 wins and 4 draws and 0 losses. It is all a script. Juventus remain unbeaten. Juventus should have 10 goals and 1 conceded. Fino alla fine, until the end. Top four, Champions League, knockouts. That's what's at stake for Juventus. Monza could be a goal differential of minus 13 if Juventus managed to win by more than a goal for the first time this year. Juve is to match 13. Juventus pick up 3 points. Juventus up 13 points, level with Udinese, level with Roma, 1 point behind Atalanta. I believe Atalanta lose their first match of the season to AS Roma. AS Roma pick up their 16th points against Atalanta because Atalanta is gematria of 16. Paulo Dybala to have a very strong performance. La Hoya Dybala against Atalanta, Bergamo Calcio. So Roma get the win. Roma is on top of the table, I should say. Roma is on top of the table. Inter right behind. Napoli and AC Milan for the right for the top of the table. I do not believe the match ends in the draw. We see an unbeaten go down at the San Siro. It has to be AC Milan for the victory. Nothing stands out with the connections as far as win-loss record goes. I do like AC Milan to pick up the victory. Milan to go on top of the table. Are Milan gonna be the defending champion again? Is Milan gonna repeat? Are we setting up a strong Milan Juventus match in a couple of weeks? Will the Juventus be back? We're about to find out. These are the Serie A matches of the week.